This is Chapter 1, Module 1, Intro to A&P. The learning objectives for this module are 1. Distinguish between anatomy and physiology. 2. Describe the levels of organization of living things. 3. Describe the 11 different organ systems in the human body. Anatomy is the oldest medical science that studies the structures of the human body. These studies were first documented in 1600 BC. Anatomy describes the structures of the body, what the structures are made of, where they're located, and other structures they are associated with. Learning anatomy is mostly using your skill of memorization. Physiology is the study of how these anatomical structures function in the body, both individually and in cooperation with other bodily functions. Sciences such as biochemistry, biology, chemistry, and genetics are all sciences that are included in physiology. Memorization and critical thinking are required to learn physiology. Anatomy can be described as gross anatomy or microscopic anatomy. Gross anatomy, also known as macroscopic anatomy, looks at large, visible structures of the body that can be seen with a naked eye. Microscopic anatomy looks at cells and molecules that can only be seen with a microscope. Studies using microscopic anatomy include cytology, which is the name given for the study of cells, and histology, which is the name given for the studies of tissues. All living things have the following 7 characteristics. Number 1. Living things are composed of cells. Even single-cell organisms have everything they need to be self-sufficient. Number 2. Living things have different levels of organization. Living things organize cells at different levels, from tissues to organs to organ systems to an organism. Number 3. Living things use energy. They take in energy and use it for maintenance and growth. Number 4. Living things respond to their environment. They make changes in response to a stimulus in their environment. Number 5. Living things grow. Cells divide, cells enlarge, and an organism gets larger as the result. Number 6. Living things reproduce. While reproduction is not essential for the survival of an individual organism, it must occur for a species to survive. Number 7. Living things adapt to their environment. Adaptations are traits giving an organism an advantage in a certain environment. The human body is organized into several different hierarchical levels of organization, meaning from smallest to largest, that include the chemical or molecular level, the cellular level, the tissue level, and the organ level. The smallest structures at the simplest level of organization are the atoms. Atoms are the smallest stable units of matter. They can combine to form a larger structure called a molecule. Large molecules combine to form organelles that are the components of cells. Cells containing these organelles are more complex than molecules. Cells are the smallest living units of matter and the smallest functional unit of the human body. Groups of cells combine to form tissues. There are 4 basic tissue types in the human body: epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscle tissue, and nervous tissue. 2 or more different tissue types can combine to form an organ. An organ has a recognizable shape and a unique function. 2 or more organs may work together to perform a common function. These organs are considered part of an organ system. There are 11 different organ systems in the human body. The highest level of organization is the organism level, where all the systems of the body work together to make a functional organism such as the human body. Here is an example of the different levels of organization in the human body. There are several different atoms that are important to life, including carbon, oxygen, and hydrogen. These atoms combine to form molecules such as DNA, carbohydrates, proteins, and lipid molecules. These molecules will combine to form organelles, such as ribosomes or mitochondria. Several different molecules combine to form a cell, for example, the smooth muscle cell. Several smooth muscle cells combine to form a smooth muscle tissue. The smooth muscle tissue combines with other tissues, such as epithelial tissue and a serous membrane, to form an organ called the stomach. The stomach works in combination with the liver, the gallbladder, the pancreas, the small and large intestine to form the digestive system. The digestive system is just one of the 11 organ systems that make up the human body at the organism level. The first organ system that we will look at is the integumentary system. This organ system will be studied in Chapter 5. The integumentary system includes major organs such as the skin, hair, sweat glands, and nails. It functions to protect against environmental hazards such as bacteria, chemicals, and extreme temperature changes. It also helps to regulate body temperature and provide sensory information to the brain. The skeletal system includes major organs such as bones, cartilages, associated ligaments, and bone marrow. This system provides support and protection for other tissues, stores calcium and other minerals, and forms blood cells. We will study the skeletal system in chapters 6, 7, 8, and 9. The muscular system includes the skeletal muscles and their associated structures. This system provides movement, provides protection and support for other tissues, and generates heat that helps to maintain body temperature. We will study the muscular system in chapters 10 and 11. The nervous system includes major organs such as the brain, the spinal cord, peripheral nerves, and sensory organs. It directs immediate responses to different stimuli. It coordinates or moderates other systems, and it provides and interprets sensory information about conditions inside and outside the body. We will study the nervous system in chapters 12 through 17. The endocrine system includes major organs such as the pituitary gland, the pancreas, the thyroid gland, the adrenal glands, the gonads, and other endocrine tissues. This system directs long-term changes in the body, such as growth and aging. It also adjusts metabolic activity and determines energy use in the body. We will study the endocrine system in Chapter 18. When you take advanced A&P, this chapter won't be studied again. However, everything you learn in this chapter will be used in great detail throughout the semester in advanced A&P. The cardiovascular system includes major organs such as the heart, the blood, and the blood vessels. This system distributes blood cells, water, nutrients, oxygen, and carbon dioxide throughout the body. The cardiovascular system also distributes heat and helps control body temperature. This system will be studied in chapters 19, 20, and 21. The lymphatic system includes major organs such as the spleen, thymus, lymphatic vessels, lymph nodes, and tonsils. This system defends the body against infection and disease and also returns fluids in the tissues back to the blood. This system is studied in chapter 22. The respiratory system includes major structures such as the nasal cavities, sinuses, larynx or voice box, trachea or windpipe, bronchi, lungs, and alveoli. This system delivers air from the environment to the lungs, delivers oxygen to the bloodstream, and removes carbon dioxide from the tissues. The respiratory system is also responsible for sounds used in communication. This system is studied in Chapter 23. The digestive system includes major structures such as the teeth, the tongue, the pharynx or throat, esophagus or food pipe, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, liver, gallbladder, and pancreas. This system digests food, absorbs water and nutrients, and stores energy reserves. The cells break down these nutrients to create a form of energy called ATP. This chemical process is called metabolism. The digestive system and metabolism are studied in chapters 24 and 25. The urinary system includes the kidneys, the ureters, the urinary bladder, and the urethra. It excretes waste products from the blood and controls water balance in the body by regulating how much urine is produced and excreted. It also regulates the concentration of ions in the blood, such as sodium and potassium. It also stores urine in the urinary bladder prior to urination. The urinary system will be studied in Chapter 26. The male reproductive system includes the testes, the epididymis, the ductus deferens, seminal vesicles, prostate gland, penis, and scrotum. The male reproductive system produces the male sex cells, called sperm, hormones, and secretions used in sexual intercourse. The female reproductive system includes the ovaries, the uterine tubes, the uterus, the vagina, the labia, clitoris, and mammary glands. This system produces the female sex cells called oocytes and hormones. This system supports the developing embryo from conception to delivery and provides milk to nourish the newborn. Both the male and female reproductive systems will be studied in Chapter 28. This ends Module 1 of Chapter 1, Intro to A&P.